Hello, my name is Paul Bevan from Siemens Digital Industries Software, and I'd like to take you through some of the enhancements to molded part design in the December 2023 release of NX. Molded part design was released in June 2023 to help reduce the cost of design iterations by providing more upfront molded part design guidance that was based on rules and experience. It also included a number of validation tools, whether that be moldability validation or individual molded part feature validation. So as I said, we've made some enhancements in this latest release, and we've added some new features. The first one I'd like to take a look at is the housing feature. Some people call it a doghouse, but it's there to provide extra strength for locating bosses or similar features. So to create the housing, all I need to do is to select a point on the part, a direction, and then apply the command. So to continue the design, I'm going to add some cooling vents on the back face of the speaker cover. Again, this is a brand new feature in this latest release. So I specify the position, again, a vector. I can modify the parameters for the size, the number of slots, the width, if I want to. Once I'm happy with my parameters, I can apply the command and the three vents have been created. So I'm going to continue to add further features to my design. I'm going to put in a couple of snap joints. Now these were included in the original release of Molded Part Design back in June 2023. So I'll add, set a couple of these snap joints. They will be used to connect the top cover to the bottom cover. And I'm going to put in a groove around this top area here to help align the two halves. And then we're going to finish off by adding some mounting bosses. And it's here that you'll see one of the other enhancements that we've added in the latest release of NX, the ability to select more than one point during the command, enabling me to create both bosses simultaneously. A real productivity boost when adding multiples of the same feature. The final enhancement to molded part design in the December 2023 release of NX that I'd like to discuss is the surface identifier. It's now possible to label specific faces within your model that may be critical and need to be taken into account either during the design process or the manufacturing process or even the analysis process. Areas that designers or any engineers need to consider when performing their tasks. And if we take a look at this case here, I'm designating this set of surfaces as Class A because they may well be seen by the end user. So they need a high quality finish. By default, we provide you with three out of the box labels, but these can also be renamed and you can add any number of your own along with an associated color to give visual clarity. And it's important to remember that for any downstream disciplines, such as CAE or manufacturing, that these surface identifiers can be viewed even without a molded part design license. So I'm just going to take a look at one other enhancement in molded part design, and that's with respect to feature validation. We've added the features as you've seen previously, but now I want to check to make sure they fall within the standards. And these standards are set in the molded part design preferences. So I'm now running the feature validation tool, and when it's completed, the molded part navigator will contain a number of validations together with color coding and visual tags. Now, some of these will just be advisory, others will be failures. you can see here at the top of this boss that it's missing a radius. So let's go ahead and fix it. So I'm going to add an edge blend to the top of this boss. And I'm also going to use select predicted objects to see if there are other edges that I need to blend. And you can see there on the other boss, it found it. I've added the blend. And now you'll see the enhancement to feature validation, the ability to do a local update. So rather than having to reevaluate all of the features, I can be more specific. So once I've done that, it reruns the validation, but only on those two bosses. And you'll see that we've now fixed the blend issue. Again, you'll notice that we have the green check mark on the one boss. The other boss, however, still has some warnings, but as they are warnings rather than errors, I'm just going to let them go for now. So let me just recap what you've seen with respect to molded part design in the December 2023 release of NX. We started by looking at the increased molded part feature support with the inclusion of the housing and the vent. We then looked at the new surface identifier, which enables the design engineer to add greater clarification to key surfaces within the model itself that can be used in downstream processes such as analysis or manufacturing. Finally, we took a look at validation, and in particular, feature validation, with the new capability of being able to perform a local update on the validation results after a design change has been performed on specific features. I'd like to thank you for your time and attention.